Every man has met me somewhere. Then one day, he walks into a bar, and there I am. He said, "Don't I know you from somewhere?" I said, "If you did, you would remember." He bought me a drink, of course. The next morning, he forgot his billfold. They often do. I don't know how men can be so careless. He said I was unforgettable. That's always a lie, of course. If something happened that was truly unforgettable, then you'd never be able to think another thought, read a paper, drive to work. It would be all you'd be able to think about, and there wouldn't be room in your head for anything else. And you'd just stand in one place and stare and think and stare and think. And after a while, they'd just have to take you away, wouldn't they?
Jeannie, let me tell you what your average man would do. Your average man, he'd wait for the water to come to a boil, 1-2 minutes. And then when the water's boiling, he'd drop in the eggs.
What happens?
Sudden cold exposed to sudden heat, remember? Eggs crack. The white stuff just oozes out. Now, the smart man, and someday, sweetheart, you'll be able to say your daddy, he taught you this. The smart man puts the eggs in the water and then turns on the heat. 5 minutes exactly. Perfection. What do you say?
Thank you.
In this house, there will be no sarcasm.
I was not being sarcastic.
Pumpkin, before it gets cold.
When will you be home?
Midnight. Well, around the holidays, we're always a little short-handed.
You work too hard.
Well, if there's a chance for overtime, I grab it. I want to provide. You know how it is.
I know how it is.
Sal's got one for the choir room.
Recent Monday. Woo, she's on the streak.
Hey, Sally, I see you hanging out with the elite.
I didn't see you in Cyril's last night. Ooh,
we've been working, Sal. Weston Avenue again?
Yeah, I was visiting your mother.
Ooh. Oh, she really got me with that last one. Really made me hurt. comedian.
I don't want them taunting you. I don't want them looking at you. I know how hard this is. I know. It's not fun out there. You look at me. You see a uniform. You say, how could she possibly understand? Would you like a Valiant?
Yes, please.
Now, what you need to do, Helen, just talk to me. Simple as that. This man who you were with tonight, I just need to know his name.
Max. He said his name was Max.
You believe him?
No.
Good. Because if you did, I'd have to say you were stupid. I don't like stupid people. Now, he said his name was Max. But what was his name?
I don't know.
Like I said, I don't like stupid people. Are you going to let me help you? Or not? This is not something that requires much thought. Now. What? His name.
Mrs. Sullivan, there's something new with your hair. You look lovely today.
Oh, thank you.
You could just feel a little bit of pressure.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
Ah, oh, there must be some mistake. Do you have an appointment? I'm booked today. If it's an emergency, I'd be happy to refer you to Dr. Fishbein. He's very good. If not, please see Dolores. Make an appointment.
I saw Dolores.
Is there a problem?
Seems you had quite a time for yourself last night. Quite a time, they tell me.
Mrs. Sullivan, we will finish this up tomorrow. Reschedule with Dolores on your way out. I regret quite deeply any inconvenience this may cause.
I don't understand. I have a hole in my tooth.
Nothing that won't keep. No harm at all. Please. Oh, sorry. That was quite unnecessary. You might have waited.
Doesn't work like that. Let's go.
Where?
Downtown.
What for? I had a beer at Ed Riley's place.
Beer. Two beers. And on your way home, you picked up somebody.
Oh, what if I did?
And then you brought her back here.
Where's the crime? They don't put you in jail for her.
The hell they don't. The girl was 15 years old.
What? She said she was...
It's not what she said. That counts, Doctor. You sat in this chair, here. You didn't even take off your shoes. You loosened your trousers and let them slide. And you spread your legs while she got down on her knees and performed a $10 service, as you requested, in the French manner. Is this coming back to you? Most men, they'd call it a night. Well, not you. You made her wait while you recuperated. And then for $10 more...
Please, stop.
You're disgusting, you know that? You're not even human. You're subhuman. Downtown.
I've got a wife, a kid, a practice.
Well, there's not a hell of a lot I can do about that now, is there?
Officer, isn't there any way that we can forget this?
Guys who ain't Roosevelt, ain't Rockefeller. Little guys, guys like you and me. When we get into a jam, it's just plain tough. Now, guys with dough, well,
how much? How much dough?
You're cut. In this room, it's the one place in the world everything stays outside that door. Like, no matter how bad things get out there. In here, we still, well, you know.
Yeah, I know. Bad world, great sex. Carl, we have to talk. What we have to talk about is I need 50. I need 50%.
I do the work.
If you feel that way.
I do the work, you come in for 50.
As of now, Carl. Starting as of now. Another John. Good one. You want him? Carl, I give you professionals. Men of means. 50's fair.
This John. What did he do, this John? What did he say? I need to know these things. What did he say to her? What did he want her to do? Maybe you could describe it for me. Maybe you could illustrate.
Would you care for a cup of coffee? I bought the good kind.
Don't go mother me now.
I was just trying to help. You know, you never come home anymore.
Hey, I'm sorry. You know, you're the best damn daughter in the world. With your mother gone, I have to be mom and dad. While sometimes it's kind of a lot for a man to do. Maybe I work too hard. Maybe I do. But I do it because I want to provide. Because I love you. Do you understand?
I understand.
And you forgive me?
You're going. You're going again.
Sugar, I promise. After the new year, we'll take a vacation.
Where were you last night?
Just the two of us. A long vacation. I'll take the money I've been saving up. We'll put it to good use.
You're no good to anybody if you don't get some sleep.
Tonight. I'll be back tonight.
When tonight?
Tonight. After dinner tonight. Now, you'll be good. Hey, there's a steak in the freezer. It's a porterhouse. The best kind. You know I only want the best for you.
You ought to at least change your shirt. That's what your average man would do. You slept in that shirt.
Johnny Cabe. You can find him every afternoon except Monday behind the bar at the Inferno. Married, 11 kids. Can you believe it? Clearly, his wife puts out. Clearly, that's not enough. I don't think Mr. Cabe knows how to keep it buttoned. 2 nights ago, he goes for a little sex. For $15 and a bottle of Seagram's. Behind the counter, no less. Now, what he likes is a certain practice involving a length of knotted rope.
Got it.
I figure a little effect like that's got to be worth at least $1,500. All that family, all those kids. A man with a business that's all cash. $1,500 minimum. What do you say?
It's Jake with me. I, may be taking a leave. I'm a little tired.
Yeah, you look like shit, you know?
So I've heard.
Tell you what. I'll go out, bring a couple of those little angels in, put the squeeze on them, get a couple of names. What do you say? You get rich, I get 50% rich. Everybody's happy.
But he's happy. That's what I like to hear. Shot of rye. I'd like a few words with you.
Everybody does.
Oh, no, not philosophy. Not advice to the lovelorn. Listen to me. I'm not a rum-dum. I'm a police officer. And I want to speak to you about an official matter.
Shoot.
There was an incident last night concerning yourself and a young woman.
What is this, a shakedown?
There was an incident. Last night?
What, last night, the night before, the night before that?
Do you know how old she was?
Oh, it's true. I like him young.
There are laws in this state.
Inferno. Yeah, let me check. Is there a detective called Streeter in here?
Yeah. Kind of trouble. Jesus Christ. Are you sure? That it's broken. That it's not, you know, just dislocated. No wallet? No ID? Well, God damn it! Was she wearing any stockings?
Oh, Carl, I can't do that. No, I can't. Damn it, Carl. She was fighting. I didn't do anything. It wasn't even an accident. I had my arm around her neck and it just snapped.
Okay. This is it, Sal. This is the only way out. Now you listen to my voice. You take that stocking and you tie one end of it around her neck. Slip knot, like a shoelace. You understand? The chair is on the floor. Like she kicked the chair away, like she did it to herself. Now, anything goes wrong. We'll play it just like we always do. I'm just another cop. Okay?
And a Merry Christmas to you, huh?
Come on, hit me! Hit me! Hit the cop!
You are not welcome here anymore. Sally Creighton's.
Uh-huh.
You know Sally, don't you?
I know who she is.
She went for coffee. When she came back, with a stocking.
Christ.
Well, it happens. I lost a few in my time. It happens.
Anything we can do, you send her home?
You might try the morgue.
I don't ever want to do this again.
It's gonna be all right.
God, I just feel so sick.
Everything's gonna be all right.
It's just a whole thing.
Man, it's out. It's all downhill.
Officer Creighton, we're going to need you to look and sign.
It's funny to say it. But maybe it's a good thing, somehow. I mean, it sounds terrible. What I mean is maybe some good will come of it.
Jeannie? Jeannie? You killed her.
Carl.
Now, officer. Now, officer.
You killed her.
Carl, it doesn't have to be this way. We can get through this. We can get through this together.
You killed Jeannie. You killed my daughter, Jeannie.
I know how hard this is for you. I know. You're looking at me, you're saying, How could she possibly understand? Carl. I love you.
Put down the gun, sir. Just put down the gun. We don't want anyone else hurt here. Let's just talk about this, okay? It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. Okay. Oh. Oh. He shot.
Governor Riley.
Yes, sir.
We were at.
Sir, okay, call it in. Homicide.
Vores serie af amerikanske film noir noveller Fallen Angels er tilbage igen på næste lørdag, 10 minutter over 1, her på TV2.